Hello, everybody. It's my pleasure to welcome you to our first developer track day ever at ZeekWeek. So that's very cool. I'm Robin Sommer. I'm the CTO and the co-founder of Corelight. I've also been leading the technical team behind Zeek for quite a while now. Started doing Zeek work in 2002-ish, I guess. So it's been a while. Worked on many different pieces of the code base in this time. And it's really exciting to see how this event has been growing even in the virtual space now. So let me show you the schedule for today. So it's a little bit different today, in particular the morning. The morning is essentially an overview of stuff that's coming in Zeek. We've structured that a little bit differently. So the various talks are actually planned for 20 minutes as well, just like the other ZeekWeek presentations that we had. But they're scheduled for 30, and that is because we are really interested in feedback. And so what we are going to do is we are going to add a Q&A and feedback on Slack at the end of each of these talks. We only have a single Slack channel for all morning. So this is the talk one roadmap. And I encourage everybody to join that channel and follow along and ask questions there. Actually, once the presentations are over, we will cut the screen sharing over into that channel so that even people who haven't joined it will actually be able to see the discussions over there. So the second block then is back to kind of the schedule from yesterday with 20-minute slots and individual channels. For this morning, so I'm excited to kick this off actually with just a bit of a high-level overview of the roadmap, both in terms of technical stuff that we have been working on and that we are planning to do, and also a bit of a update on development processes that we have been establishing over recent months. And then the following talks will be going into more detail on a number of these larger item topics. So let me get that going. So the next big Zeek release that's coming up, scheduled by the end of the year, is 4.0, which will be another LTS release, a long-term supported release, which means that just like with 3.0, we will be supporting this version for a year with patch releases. And just as a reminder, it also means that generally we try to retain backwards compatibility between like those LTS releases. So that means for people who have been on 3.0, that the time is coming to update to 4.1. And generally to kind of recap our release cadence that we are in now, and which I think is working pretty well at this point, is that these LTS releases, they come about once a year, or pretty much exactly once a year. And then we have additional feature releases and they come every 4 months. So, and that means 4.0 will be for those people who are still on 3, they will be catching up a bit on stuff that's already out in feature releases. Feature release means maybe as a bit of context, because I'm hearing sometimes some questions about this. Feature releases are stable and ready for production as well. So even these every 4 month releases are something we recommend for using. They may be a bit more disruptive because stuff changes more quickly. In particular, those .1 releases, because that's where some of the deprecated functionality often goes out. So as I said, 4.0 is a bit of catching up for those who are still on 3. So let me just recap quickly the main features that we have pushed out with 3.1. That is the new I/O loop, which is actually quite a substantial revamp of kind of the core of Zeek. That's where all the packets come in and need to be processed efficiently. And the main user visible impact that you will be noticing here is that even on a low volume link, the CPU usage of Zeek will not longer be idling around at 20%, but it will actually go appropriately down as a low traffic volume would suggest. So that is a long-term issue that has been fixed there. We have added a supervisor framework in a first version. I'll be talking about later, actually more on this in the management framework talk. We have added VXLAN support. And on changes, a nice little feature for script level tables where you can get a notification in script land if a table changes. I wanted to put on the radar for those who are still on 3.0 that with 3.1, and that means also with 4.0, everything that has been deprecated originally in 3.1 will be or has moved out with 3.1. That means in particular all the name changing stuff, all those backwards compatibility links and workarounds that we had in there, they are all gone. So for those updating, this might be a bit more disruptive. Zeek 3.2, our most recent stable release, added broker-backed tables, which is something you can now tie a script-level table to a broker store on disk, and that essentially gives you persistent state across cluster nodes, which is a pretty cool feature for retaining information you have derived from traffic long-term. We added certificate caching to improve the performance of OX549 analysis. We added essentially overloading for event prototypes, meaning it's easier for us to keep backwards compatibility in the future. And under the hood, actually, there's a lot of C++ code modernization going on that users won't see. They usually don't see unless they're compiling plugins, maybe. But it's actually moving us forward. And I heard it from a couple of people that if you are used to the Zeek code base as it used to be, and you look at the current versions, there has a lot of change. A lot of things have been changing to the better, and that is in the sense of being just more modern and more safe. So we have switched a lot of code over to smart pointers for manual reference counting. We have introduced these namespaces Zeek and Zeek Detail, which first makes it easier to work with third-party code, but also go back into our LTS guarantee. So at the code level, in particular for people writing plugins, everything in the we first deprecate something before we later remove a feature or change it in a non-backwards compatible way. So that applies to everything in the Zeek namespace. It does not apply to stuff in the Zeek detail namespace. There we will be more liberal in making changes. It's still accessible, so we're not hiding what's in detail, but we don't make guarantees about that. Zeek 3.2 also came actually with some nice benchmarking infrastructure to find performance regressions. On top of this, there's lots of actually smaller stuff, events, options, finite logs, language extents, and the news file summarizes this. Let's switch to 4.0. So this is stuff that has not been in any release yet. However, what's on this slide, I can guarantee you it will be in 4.0 because it's already committed to Git Master. So if you check out the current development version, you have this here. The largest change, and actually maybe one of the largest changes in a while, is that we are making lower level analyzers or lower level protocol analysis, the layer two essentially, pluggable. So we added a plugin API for that. There will be a presentation on that. And it actually went beyond layer two at this point. And we have some new log filter policy hooks, which kind of are superseding the log filter predicates, which were hard to chain. So it makes it easier to actually filter logs in terms of what you want to have in there. We have a nice new state management tool if you want to hook into connection state remove, essentially, but not for all connections, just for some. You can now like individually register them, which helps performance quite a bit if you're really only interested in cleaning up for a few connections and you're not don't need all those SYN scans to handle as well. We have a new dictionary implementation under the hood, which was an external contribution. Those who were at Zeek Week last year actually heard about that. So that has been merged in. We have a bunch of further performance improvements, some smaller, some larger ones. I think that will overall help things quite a bit, and lots of more C++ code modernization. So this is a theme currently. And again, events, options, extended logs, language extension. There's always actually a lot of non-big ticket items, but still interesting. So I really encourage everybody to look at news and to hit the point home. I did a bit of statistics. It's amazing to realize that since 3.0, there were 2,000 commits going into master. And we have about 370 branches merged. That's quite an exciting number. And it's an indicator of how much is going on in the Zeek space. So let's come to some future stuff. So this is stuff which is still on the roadmap for 4.0. Quite a bit, I think, of this will make it in one version or the other. Not all of it will make it because we were kind of at this point, we are halfway through. So we have to see how far we can push some of these. But I think the first point, for example, in particular, moving IP into this new packet analyzer structure that I mentioned and that we will hear more about, that is a PR that is under review right now and I think almost ready to be merged, which actually in the end means that we will be moving away from having IP hard-coded in Zeek. Zeek will be able to analyze non-IP protocols in the future the moment we add the next bullet item, the configurable connection IDs, which literally means we have some notion of a unique connection independent of the IP protocol. We want to start moving policy scripts into packages to just kind of align better with that new ecosystem that ZKG has, our package manager has created and really stimulated. And that means some of the policy scripts you currently have in the distribution really just don't feel like they are at the appropriate place anymore. And there will be a separate presentation on this this morning as well. We are working on a Zeek script compiler for optimizing execution speed. And that is an experimental feature, quite a big change, that at least partially, I think we will kind of be able to at least merge in the infrastructure changes for that, perhaps more. And we will see how far we go. Vern will be talking about that later. We are currently working towards a new Zeek management framework that is meant to eventually replace Zeek control. We have made a few steps towards that. And for 4.0, at this point, the main goal is to really like finalize the design for that new framework. And again, that will be a separate presentation. I'm still planning to overhaul the logging for SSL X509 to kind of make that more or less messy, I would say. For broker, there is a quite a large change under the hood coming. And that is, we are adding essentially an overlay network to broker that supports routing across hops. And that means we will be able to do publish subscribe based on topics across larger topologies of broker nodes, independent of you have like a full mesh connection as we currently require. So this will really give us a lot of flexibility for distributed settings, for things like the Zeek agent that we heard about yesterday, and really be able to kind of build routed topologies. And we have quite a bit of performance improvements in both broker and CAF under the hood. And there's more C++ modernization coming. So again, this is all kind of on the screen. We will see how far we can push some of these, but it will be pretty cool. Outside of the main code base, so there are two new affiliated projects that I just wanted to briefly mention here, because for both we have, again, independent presentations. One is SPICY, which is a new C++ parser generator for parsing protocols on files, and that is meant to eventually replace BINPACK. And the punchline is here that SPICY allows you to add new analyzers to Zeek without writing a single line of C++ code. This is essentially in beta at the moment, so interested in feedback, people can just go to that GitHub repository and giving it a try. And the goal is as well to align a first stable 1.0 release with a 4.0 Zeek release at the end of the year. Zeek agent we heard yesterday about from Vergy, and that is an endpoint agent that for the first time makes stuff going on the host that Zeek is not able to see or observe itself available to Zeek via broker by sending events into the scripting layer. So, and this supports Linux, Mac OS, and Windows at the moment to different degrees. And it integrates with OSQuery, as you have heard yesterday, for being able to tap into all that interesting information that OSQuery makes available. So this is also out at this GitHub repository. Both projects are, as always, BSD licensed. They have, by the way, a dedicated Slack channel. So if you have any feedback on those, that's the right place to go. SPICY and Zeek agent. In addition to technical work, and again, we will hear more about a bunch of these pieces in subsequent talks, but in addition to technical work, we have been focusing quite a bit on documenting and refining our development processes. And just to summarize this, you can actually find a lot of documentation now in the wiki on GitHub. We have documents describing all this in more detail, but to quickly summarize it, we have of course our code of conduct, which is kind of the starting point for everything else. You want to just ensure that working on Zeek is fun for everybody, right? And that's really the goal there. The development roadmap, well, we keep being asked about like writing that down. It's hard because it keeps changing so much. So what we've tried to do is be more diligent with using the issue tracker and marking the milestones. So I think it's pretty safe at this point to go to the GitHub issue tracker and filter for milestone, and you see what's on the roadmap. Watch out, a couple of sub projects have their own tracker, Spicy, for example, also Broker. And the wiki page summarizes that. We have written down kind of what are the technical roles and projects that are part of Zeek, of the Zeek project. How do people get into these roles, and how does a new project like Spicy or like the Zeek agent come under the Zeek umbrella? And that is something, if you're interested in that, it kind of really lays out like they're essentially the external contributors. There are team members, which are people with a bit of a track record and involvement with the project, and they're merge masters, which are the people who have commit privileges into the master Git repository. And the document lays out what are the criteria for getting into these roles. And that, of course, is in the spirit of being more open for other people joining these various teams in their respective roles. We are in the process of defining what kind of platform support we want to kind of commit to, I would say, in the sense of what are we supporting for Zeek going forward. And the first thing we did is actually publish on the wiki a matrix of supported platforms right now. You can see where it compiles, where we're actually building binaries for and what's in CI. And we're working on a new policy that actually lays out, like going forward, what platforms are, what is the policy per platform in terms of how far back in particular we are supporting older distributions. And the bottom line is that I think what we are converging on at this point is that we will use our CI system as the oracle. So we will have a per distribution, particularly per Linux distribution policy, like in terms of their respective support policies, and we will put them into our CI. And basically, when it passes CI, then we can, for example, use a new C++ feature. I mean, that's one of the drivers here. So that is the criteria. If it passes CI on the platforms you have in there, then it's okay to use. I wanted also to point out that we wrote down our security release process. How do people report security issues and how do we handle them? And one part of that is that we developed a classification for vulnerabilities, just to have essentially a language to speak here. And you see we have critical, high, medium, low, no risk. Critical is the bad stuff, remotely exploitable and really giving attackers essentially access to systems or information. High is something which kind of impacts but is not catastrophic. Medium requires local system access of some kind. And based on these classifications, we are committing to getting patch releases out in a certain time interval. And you see that on the right-hand side of the slide here. And that doesn't mean it will always take us that long, but it's basically what we felt comfortable in terms of committing to as the longest period that might take us. If you look at our track record for the 3.0 series, we are currently at 11 patch releases. Most of them were security of one kind or the other, and we were often quite a bit faster in getting them out. We also assembled a Zeek security team, basically making these judgment calls. What is the classification? What's the fix? How do we get it out? And that is both people on the core team, but it's also a few external people so that we have that expertise there as well. Finally, what's also on the wiki in the process section there is a contribution guide. So if you are interested in getting code into Zeek, there's a lot of information how to approach that. And I wanted to mention two things here. One is that generally our discussions are open and generally public and to everybody involved, and you can participate. So if you pretty much all or most of the if you take like one-on-one discussions out, but all group discussions happen out in the open. So you find a lot of on the issue tracker, on pull requests, Slack, mailing lists, and that's the places you can go to and contribute and voice your opinions. If you want to contribute a code of your own, if it's something small, just go ahead and open a pull request. We'll work with you to get that in. If it's a larger piece of work, if you have really something you want to build, you want to change, that is more core to Seek itself, then the best way to approach that is preparing a little proposal that we can provide feedback on, and then we can jointly iterate on that. And that is a process that we are doing ourselves actually as well. So you will often see either in tickets or on again mailing the Slack, like pointers to proposals, ideas, designs about things we are working on. For example, for the script optimization branch that Vern is working on, we have a ticket and we have now like a document that just kind of summarizes information what would it take to merge this actually. If you're looking for something specific to work on and don't have your own ideas, there's GitHub and you can just ask us. Maybe my final piece here is that even if you don't contribute code, what's most helpful in practice is actually feedback. So if you see anything you like or you don't like, let us know. Provide feedback, provide input, how we could do things different, what's good, and where we need to be careful. That concludes my initial talk. So I'm excited to pass on to the others in a little bit. Until then, we do this discussion on Slack, and we will actually, I think, now cut over this video stream to the Slack channel. So looking forward to see you all there.